Rules allow us to say in advance, I'd like something specific to happen when a message comes in or goes out, whether that message is about a particular topic or from a particular person or meets some other criteria that we can specify. Rules are email-based wonders. For example, I'm working with Tammy and Victor on this CRM project. Every email that comes in from Jake is going to go to the CRM project. I can create a rule so that email that comes from Jake goes automatically to the CRM project folder. Or I can create a rule that says anytime an email comes in from Jake, I'd like to forward it to the CRM project group. Or I can create a rule that does both. I have lots and lots of options here. I just need to decide what it is I want to be able to do. Let's create that first rule. Notice that I can right-click, go to rules, and it says always move messages from Jake. That's kind of cool. They've made it super easy to be able to do this. I want to show you the more verbose way to do this, but let me show you what that looks like. It's simply a matter of choosing a folder. We'd choose CRM project, click OK, and the rule would be created, but I would like to actually do a little bit more than that. Let's go to rules, create rule. I'm going to say, when I get an email from Jake, every email that comes from Jake, I'd like to move the item to a folder, and the folder I'd like to move it to is CRM project. Now, I have some other choices. I can display a new item alert. I can play a selected sound. If I do either of those things, Outlook has to do them. And what that means is that Outlook has to be running for this rule to run. The problem with that is, in this circumstance, I want to be able to forward stuff to my team even when I'm not here. So I'm going to leave off the things that have to happen locally. Display a new item alert for Jenny, play a selected sound on Jenny's computer, and say, just move the item to the folder, which is something that Exchange can handle for me with no problems. Now let me click Advanced Options and show you just how rich this gets. Here is the rules wizard. This is step one. Select the condition. I'm saying it's from Jake. But notice all these other choices. What if I wanted all of my emails that come from Microsoft.com to go to one place? Then what I could do is I could say with specific words in the sender's address, and the specific words would be Microsoft.com in the address. This is all of the emails from one company, for example. Let's cancel that. I'm going to remove it. But notice that we have lots of choices about what we do. Comes from Jake, I could say, also say it comes from Jake and my name is in the tour CC box. Or it comes from Jake, sent only to me. You have a lot of choices to be able to very finely describe exactly what it is you're looking for. It comes from Jake and it has an attachment, for example. But in this case, comes from Jake is good enough. What I'd like to do then when it comes from Jake is I'd like to move it to the specified folder. And I could stop processing more rules, but I'm not going to do that yet. I'm going to move it to the specified folder. And I am also going to forward it to people or a public group. Check this out. What might my group be? Well, and did you catch that word public? If I'm going to forward it to a group, it needs to be a public group. I can't forward it to a private group. I could, however, forward it to specific individuals. What that means, though, is that if we added individuals to the list, I'd need to come back in here and modify my rules. You begin to see how these pieces go together. The power of creating a group means that when I add people to the group and I am using rules to forward an email to that group or anyone sending emails to the group, Microsoft Outlook and Exchange are automatically handling the membership of that group and sending this to the right people. What else can I do? I can flag this if I wish. I can automatically print it, but again, that would be a local rule because there's a local printer. All of these items at the bottom where we are playing sounds and starting applications, all of these really are going to prevent the rule from running unless Outlook is turned on. So that's the second step, actions. Third step, exceptions. What I'm going to do here is try to imagine any email I might get from Jake that I wouldn't want to send to anyone. And everything I'm getting from Jake right now is about this project and this vendor relationship. It wouldn't hurt for me to say that to Jake. That would be a good idea. I'm automatically forwarding all of your emails to my entire team. That would be great. click next. And then the last thing is to name this. And because I started this by saying all of the emails that come from Jake, it's using his name as the rule, but I'm going to say forward FWD Jake to CRM team. If I wish, I can run this rule now on messages already in the inbox. And as soon as I click finish, then Exchange and Outlook will rip through my inbox and automatically forward all those messages. Or I can turn it off and only use it going forward. At any point in time, I can turn this rule on or off. One use of rules then is to create rules that help you move items to other folders or forward emails to other people that you invoke on a periodic basis. I move all of the messages to client folders, for example, at the end of every quarter or the end of every year. You can simply go into the rules, run the rule on the messages, and when you're all done, turn the rule back off. But in this case, I'm going to run this on messages and turn this rule on going forward so that in the future, all messages that we get from Jake will automatically be forwarded to the project team and placed in the CRM project folder. There we go. Now, there was an email here from Jake. You know where that went. My copy of it is in the CRM project folder right here. And the group should have an email coming in from Jake as well. That might take a second longer to get there. Here it is right now. Whether you are forwarding email messages to a team, automatically replying to emails that you receive, marking messages as read, applying categories, Outlook rules will help you do all of these things automatically.